If we I now conceive this feverish agitation as it operates in the market of the whole world. We shall be in a position to comprehend how the growth, accumulation, and concentration of capital bring in their trade, an ever more detailed subdivision of labour, an ever greater improvement of old machines, and the constant application of new machines, a process which goes on uninterruptedly, with feverish haste, and upon an ever more gigantic scale. But what effect do these conditions, which are inseparable from the growth of productive capital, have upon the determination of wages? The greater division of labour enables one labourer to accomplish the work of 5, 10, or 20 labourers. It therefore increases competition among the labourers 5-fold, 10-fold, or 20-fold. The labourers compete not only by selling themselves one cheaper than the other, but also by doing the work of 5, 10, or 20. And they are forced to compete in this manner by the division of labour, which is introduced and steadily improved by capital. Furthermore, to the same degree in which the division of labour increases, is the labour simplified. The special skill of the labourer becomes worthless. He becomes transformed into a simple, monotonous force of production, with neither physical nor mental elasticity. His work becomes accessible to all. Therefore, competitors press upon him from all sides. Moreover, it must be remembered that the more simple, the more easily learned the work is, so much the less is its cost to production, the expense of its acquisition, and so much the lower must the wages sink. For, like the price of any other commodity, they are determined by the cost of production. Therefore, in the same manner in which labour becomes more unsatisfactory, more repulsive, do competition increase and wages decrease.